said no, it has to be down this high in front of our guru, because this is one of the gurus that we can see in lifetime. So I thank you, sir, for attending my presentation. My presentation today is about best practice as inspiration journey. And really, this is what I believe, this is what I practice, at least in the last 7 years approximately. We say that inspiration is about spirit of persistence. So we need to, all of you here, you are change agents for us, for the whole world. The whole world need always inspiration. And sometimes we go down and, you know, we see, especially in this part of the world, we really need inspiration from everyone. Because as you can see, the black spots is more than the white spots in this area. There's lots of wars, there's a lot of hatred, lots of racism, and so on, segregation, alienation, you name it. And the spirit of coexistence is not there. So we need a lot of inspiration in this part of the region. Thank you for coming all the way, especially people coming outside the region. Now, the concept of inspiration is usually linked also to learning from best practices. And there's lots of case studies and papers that came, and books also, that came about this. And I remember reading the last book of Dr. Harrington, our guru. Also, he talking about this, especially in the area of innovation and inspiration. Also, the opportunity towards competitiveness is very high. To be competitive, the word competitive, it means you have to be agile. And agility, it means very hard to copy. Agility, actually, if you look at it in the dictionary, is about balancing, the ability to balance. I'm not a good model, of course, but it's like in Arabic, we say bahlawan, like the one in the circus, how he walk, you know, around, you know, on the rope, yes, and his ability to go fast. This is the word agility. Competitiveness is about hard to copy. And being hard to copy, it means that you have to learn. The more you are, you are open to learn, earn, return, you are really able to be competitive. So remember these three L's, learn, earn, return. It's very important for us is that we have this mindset, open mindset, for us, for the organization, and for the society. And of course, learning by doing is one of the best practices to help you to move from, to get inspired and to move to the second stage. Learning from best practice also one of the highest trends today in the world. Appreciation for the need of change is what's gonna be created if you do learning by doing or learn from best practice. You, even your top management will be appreciating the need of change. And one of the most difficult changes is that middle management create the change. We're not lucky always to have leaders like this country, for example, Mohamed bin Rashid, or, you know, leaders like today, we've seen Al Jazeera, for example, catering and others that are attending with them and they are helping them in change. Most of the organizations suffer, they are not inspired because their top management resisting change. So for that, we should do lots of learning by doing learning from best practice so that we create the change in the organization. The second level, once we are starting to get inspired, we'll start to understand the need of change. Even the organization people will start to feel that there is a need for change. Even your society maybe get inspired because of this. And once you do this learning from best practices and you share this learn, air, return cycle and starts there in the organization, you're gonna go for managing the change. And this is the most difficult because always change, we have a formula for change. It's about dissatisfaction, then people move for a model like best practice. And then the most difficult one is the P, called process of managing change. And most failures does not happen. I don't think today we have a problem of creating a dissatisfaction or measuring something and telling the people you are having this problem. And I don't think today with all this knowledge we have around and with FQM and other models, Malcolm Partridge and all, and Kaizen, like also our presenter talked about it earlier, all of these is helping us to create models and lots of models that we can create because of this. But the most difficult is really, as I said, sustaining the change, and this is where is the most difficult. And then, of course, evolving change. Once you really can manage the change, you start to see how you evolve the change. And I think, inshallah, yani lots of the cases that we've seen in these organizations, they can start to find opportunity for, of competitiveness, which will be different. This is what makes us or move us to a status called realization. Most of our organizations, even the top organization, even the organization that got awards from yani FKM or they implemented business excellence, you'll find that sometime, and most of the times, they think they are aware and they don't know how much they are unaware. And the issue here is always we'll fight as a change agent or we'll try our best as a change agent inside our organization to let them feel that still they are learning towards getting realization. And the word realization, I mean putting concepts into reality, making people really feel that they can put concepts into reality instead of talking about it or doing presentations about it. And this is the most source for inspiration, by the way. Once people start to realize how much they don't know, they'll start to get inspired. The blockage for any inspiration is that you think you know, and you don't know how much you don't know. And this is really, it makes us, run our life cycle without understanding this. This type of conference is one of the, or this type of competition, it helps us a lot to enhance. I believe also the site visits, the observations will help us a lot. The more we do site visits, and even the top management, they come down, it will help us going to the Gemba, as earlier presenter spoken about. From my experience all over the world, I can tell you that I've gone all over the world. I attended more than 300 major projects, okay, in 12 countries, and I can tell you best practice is the best tool, really, for organization level, not for self level, for inspiration level to learn from. So encourage most of organizations around you and your society also to do that. Studying, I have a book that's coming up now about inspiration economy, relevant to the journal that Dr. Robin, he's one of the founders, by the way, with us. If you study Omar ibn Abdul Aziz, one of the major people who came in our life, and he was not from the golden era. He was in not the golden era. He came later, but really he inspired the world. And this guy, he only stayed in his position for 18 months, but he made a major change. Same thing when we study and we see Ibn Khaldun, which is most of the books now give reference to him when they talk about anthropology and so on. And especially when we see also Gandhi and what he did to the world. They are not angels. They are normal people like you and like me. But the only thing, they started to realize. They started to get inspired. And they believe that inspiration is not only for them. It's for the whole society. It shouldn't be limited to certain people. And especially when Einstein came. Einstein, one of his unique things that he started to see his chances. He became not a physicist. He became not a mathematician. He became really a philosopher. The most whatever Einstein have said today, we use it for a lot of inspiration in our journals and so on. Mandela, this guy, nobody believed that staying in such long time in jail, he can change the world even when he was in jail and even after jail. And this is after his death also. Now he's a source of inspiration for lots of things, and maybe coexistence is one of the top. And of course, jobs. Really, these things make us at some time. We believe that each one of you today who attended, I consider them outliers. You should be out of the norm. You should try your best to really inspire the world by really considering that you are a lifelong learners. The most important is that you believe you are lifelong learners and you have something to share or to inspire the world. Not only top people or thinkers and so on can change the world. And I believe that coming to the grips with the need to capture the essence of best practice, and what is it about? What is the values? Maybe you've seen most of my questions. What is the values you're gonna give me? What is the inspiration they want to inspire me? Maybe I missed it. And this is very important, is that we talk about this for everyone we talk about when we present. Because at the end of the day, people will not change unless they do either one of two. Either they go to the Gemba or to the field, and they practice, and their behavior and their mindset will change. Or we really inspire them by our model, the models that you were talking about. And this, of course, will create for us the change in mindset, the change in the spirit, and the change in the heart. People change if they find these three issues, plus the content. If they find a good content in front of them, they change. So we need always, when we talk and we present our best practices, is we talk about the heart, we talk about the mind, we talk about the spirit, and we talk about the content. These are whatever is the criteria for the presentation you are doing. If you don't cover this, then you will not inspire me. And this is very important that we cover this whenever we talk about any presentation. So this is what I was talking about. People will change their paradigm, their behaviors, only when they see that there is something, frankly, is that something to respond to, something they can learn, something they can actually observe or absorb or reflect. So the reflection or absorption. Yes, thank you, sir. Okay. This is agility, by the way. Let's give him a hand. Okay. Yes. Okay. So remember, your goal is really to create a proper observation. And if you have been lucky to create a proper observation, then we are talking about, thank you, sir. So we are talking about proper observation will make us more able to get inspired. Okay, so we'll get what we call absorption. يعني تشبع باللغة العربية. And once we get absorbed, we'll be more able to get reflection. And once you start a reflection, you are the sun now. Okay, so you are now the sun. You can inspire lots of organizations. Let me talk quickly about, before Robin comes, concept of inspiration. All of us, we are either upgrading, driven inspiration. We was brought, we were lucky, some of us, that our parents has taught us how to get inspired, how to get persistent. But most of us, we are not in this area. Most of us, either we are waiting for organization to inspire us, or we are waiting for environmental-driven inspiration to inspire us, okay? But when we talk about really what we are looking for is today, well, by the way, in this part of the world, we are not looking a lot for the area of innovation only. And I claim that we don't need today to be creativity also driven. We're supposed to be discovery driven. And the word discovery, if you go back to the word discovery, it's about discovering nature. You need to discover your nature first in order to help others to get inspired. And very important that we remember, we need the fourth part beside, we need the three parts. Inner self-driven inspiration that we look for. And this is supposed to be each one of us inspiring others and doing the learn and return that I've spoken about. We live in a society that's all about moral character and performance character. We evaluate people always through these two issues. And we're talking about here respect, responsibility to others, you know these things, or commitment to continuous improvement, goal setting, and so on. But at the end of the day, we are really, without really putting our efforts towards moral characteristics, we're gonna create non-profit organizations. Let's remember this. Organizations that is non-value added. They will not be, first of all, profitable. And beside that, they will not be healthy because they cannot communicate properly because of their, again, performance character. Best practice does not happen by coincidence. Best practice, it happened that someone has got inspired from somewhere, from a conference, from attending something or doing something himself, or reading a book, and then he start to discover the power within himself. And these are the hidden powers. I have written on one of my books, it's called Road to Competitiveness. It's in Arabic. It's about the power of the observation that we are missing. And this power of observation is very important. We observe things, we should love the thing that, as I told you, so that we understand it. Or power of variety, or power of willingness, or power of common sense. And then we start to discover lots of powers. Power of appreciating others, power of discovering our capacity, power of feeling that we need to learn, power of humbleness, power of coexistence, power of knowledge sharing, and power of trust, and then power of focus. These powers will help us, and power of honesty, of course, and communication. All these powers will be discovered once you start to have this power of observation. So again, as I said, this will help you a lot towards moving on the ladder of inspiration. If you want to reach reflection, it doesn't happen by coincidence. You have to be a good observer and a good absorber, of course. And here you have to be very humble. Actually, what Gandhi taught us, you have to create humility. You have to create humility sometime to yourself so that you remember that the amount of your unawareness is much more than the amount of your realization so that you get inspired. Because once people think they got everything in life and they got all the truth, they will never get inspired anymore, okay? And they, as Gordon Brown, the ex-prime minister of, this, I think he's a lucky guy, by the way, because he discovered himself more when he left the government. This prime minister earlier, before Tony Blair. What he said? He said, we can live without water for a few days. We can live without air for a few seconds. But living without inspiration, we're dead. Okay, so very important is that we remember this is life. Life is all about inspiration. It is about need to improve our operation, need to respond to events in a proper way. And this is, as I said, the spirit of agility. Then we come to learning from best practices. There are five reasons and five examples that that we are living for to inspire people to learn more. This is one of the purposes we are here. To let people know It is easy, and it is the foundation to be more stronger, to show that anyone can achieve this. Your purpose is not to get the award. Your purpose is not to get the certificates. You didn't come all the way for that. Your success and each one's success of you is that you inspired us, all of us, okay? And this is very important that we remember this when we share our best practices. To show that there are millions of ways to achieve our goals. Today, if I were you, I will go to, I'll call my son or my daughter, and I'll tell them, Baba or Mama, that I did an inspiration for others. I managed to inspire others. I worth to be living here. I would like you to be like me to inspire others. And then to show that it's not a rocket science to inspire others and to share best practice. And there is lots of ways. I can see him is coming around. So I can skip this. You can take it in the presentation. The whole purpose of, by the way, of best practices is not about learning. The first cycle of moving inspiration is about unlearning. Because the most blockage for us is that when someone presents something, oh, I know that. I heard that before. No, you didn't know that. The way they have done it, it is in their society, it's in their condition, it affected their heart, their mind, their spirit. For sure, if you are a good observer, you get inspired from it. So very important that we remember the first cycle of best practice is start with unlearning, and then comes with a model of reference. So don't care about model of reference unless you unblock your blockages, which is the cycle of learning that we know all about. And then we come to the last part, which is opportunity towards competitiveness. Let's remember, we are not working about strategies and structure. Yes, what the IFCM leader said earlier, it's about a strategy and so on. But at the end of the day, it's meant to be where? Affecting the hidden part of the organization. This is where people get inspired, really. The other people have to do it. The second one, people, if they are alone, they don't need to do it, okay? So this is very important as we work for values, for attitudes, for beliefs, and for behaviors, and for our cultures. Changing our cultures, sustaining our cultures, and to be changed. This is what move us from supply versus demand to capacity versus demand. What we need in this world today is not materialistic issues. We need raising capacities. People in lots of areas of the world, even now in Europe now. See, you can see the war is coming there, okay? So very important is that people believe that they are capable of creating the change. Not the politicians only can change the world for us. And this is very important that we remember the cycle of change, which I have to skip for. And then we remember that it's about, at the end of the day, it's about learning and realizing that will help us to create better action. Learn and return is the area where we can change. I will again reflect back here that we have a journal, and we'd like to see more journals, inshallah. When you search in the internet, you'll not find lots of journals about inspiration and its relevance to the society change and to the economy. So I would encourage everyone, and one of the founders.